نبدأ الشكل.
إن شاء الله. أوكي، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله ومن والاه. اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى، ولك الحمد ما رضيت، ولك الحمد بعد الرضا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد في كل وقت وحين. So today إن شاء الله this is story still linked with the verb. Again, to remind you, لنذكركم, to remind you. الكلمات في اللغة العربية ثلاثة أنواع: اسم وفعل وحرف. ضمائر: اسم وفعل وحرف. ده ضمائر. هو say louder. هو هي أنا أنت ضمائر. Okay, this is اسم. أني ضمير is اسم. كم مرش with the فعل. The ضمير can be mixed, so can make one word, اسم, which is ضمير, and فعل, yes. You know, you say, أكرمني, he was generous with me. أكرمت, I was generous with someone. أكرمته, I was generous with him. أكرمتها, I was generous with her. You know, أكرمنا, someone was generous with us. أكرمناهم, we were generous with them. This is very, very important. Very, very important. So today we talk about how we link the verb with the pronoun and what is the meaning. So we study the pronoun separately, we study the verbs separately. Now we're going to join the two of these classes, the genering, the pronoun, I mean the pronoun and the verb, okay? Let's go here. So let's take another one. One table here. This is very good, mashallah. So we can take it here, we can write down over. Okay, bismillah. No, we don't need it. Yeah, we don't need it. Okay. So let's see the verb, the video, inshallah.
قبل ما نشرح درس النهارده تعالوا مع بعض نفتكر درس قديم ونراجع برضه على الفعل الصحيح والمعتل. احنا عارفين طبعا الفرق ما بين الفعل الصحيح والفعل المعتل. الفعل المعتل في حرف من حروف العلم الالف و
Here, guys, this is he review some class he gave it to the student. He said there is many types of verb. I know this is very, very complicated, but inshallah it will be clear with you. There is two types of fi'l. Al-fi'l يعني verb. Fi'l صحيح. صحيح mean correct. وفعل معتل. صحيح same word in Urdu. We say صحيح. صحيح.
صحيح.
صحيح يعني
صحيح.
correct.
Correct, yeah.
صحيح or صحيح. صحيح in Arabic mean correct. Yep. And صحيح البدن he has a good health. صحيح. In the hadith say, أنت صدق وأنت صحيح. صحيح. You know. صحيح mean have a good health. You know. So صحيح. But for verb, صحيح mean correct. And there is فعل معتل. معتل from علة in Arabic means sick. The verb is sick. Why the verb is sick? We'll give you example now. You will know why the verb is sick. The verb can be sick, yes.
الفعل الصحيح اللي خلت حروفه الأصلية من حرف علة وعلشان أح
معطل also means like
broken.
Oh, this is different types of verb. Oh, I'm trying to remove this thought. It's not
Weekend. You want me to connect my phone?
That's
I don't
okay.
have advertisement.
Inshallah.
I have a subscription where the advertisement sells.
Yeah, inshallah. I will inshallah to fix it. Okay, guys. Okay. So he said, فعل صحيح, there is no حروف علة. حروف العلة, let me write it here. حروف العلة is three. I'll give you example to summarize the difference between صحيح and معتل. The class is إسناد الأفعال للضمائر. This is that the address will work on it. But he said side information الفعل صحيح صحيح and معتل. صحيح يعني there is no حرف علة. It's correct. لا كتب معتل is there is حرف علة in the beginning or middle or end. Like وعى قام سعى. So حرف العلة is one of the why. Why in Arabic? Any فعل contains واو ألف ياء in the beginning like وعى. وعى mean he realize. قام he get up or he stand up. سعى he walk. But سعي different from مشى. مشى or سعى. مشى mean he walks. سعى mean he walks but faster, a little faster. That's why we say السعي بين الصفا والمروة. We don't say المشي. المشي like you walk. السعي like this. And this is different from جرى. جرى يعني ران. So we have word for each speed.
يمشي means what?
يمشي يعني slow. يمشي walk. But يسعى يعني run. وجاء رجل من أقصى المدينة يسعى. Some man came hurry. The Prophet Musa on the story of Yasin. وجاء من أقصى المدينة رجل يسعى. يسعى يعني walking faster. And this is when you go to الصفا والمروة you have to walk like this. Not to walk like this. You know, this is مشى. We don't say, we can say مشى بسرعة. He walk faster. But in Arabic, we don't need two words. If we can express the meaning by one word, we don't need two words. We are not in English. This is Arabic. So, masha, يعني he walk. Mostly likely slow. Not very slow, but slow. Sa'a, faster. Jara. You know, and there is another word for more speed. If you run slow, you run fast, you run. There is another, you know. There is ikfaharra. Ikfaharra, يعني when the big stone comes from the top of mountain. This is ikfaharra. Or when the horse coming from high area to down area. How is the speed? Ikfaharra. We don't use this word in Arabic. But this Arabic flowing. So we have a word for each speed. In the walking and running and that's why when the Quran express one word, Quran mean this word. This word express, we cannot switch it. If you switch it, you cannot change it, something in the meaning. So let's go here. Let's go these two definitions, two new definitions for you. فعل صحيح, يعني free from, واو ألف ويا. Be careful. ألف, not همزة. So when you say أتى, أتى, for example, أتى فعل صحيح or معتل؟
صحيح.
No, معتل.
Because
of يعني. Not because of همزة. No. أتى, you know, but if you say قام, there is ألف in the middle. قام, صام, نام, جاء. That's because of that. Okay, here سعى in the end, أتى in the end. Wa'a in the beginning and end. There is different types also from Mu'tal and Sahih. But this is very, very important types of verb, inshallah. you have to know it. صحيح أم معتاد؟ Let's continue. And the فعل الصحيح there is مهموس. مهموس. مهموس mean started with همزة. مهموس يعني we name every kind of verb, you know. مهموس.
زلزلة. طيب الفعل الصحيح لو في ثلاث حروف ومن الهمزة والضعيف ومن حرف العلة بنسميه صحيح سالم. كل ده احنا عارفينه طبعا قديم. صحيح سالم يعني سالم من حروفه من الهمزة والتضعيف وحروف العلة كمان، زي كتب ذهب ده اسمه صحيح سالم. يبقى احنا عرفنا كده الفعل الصحيح. طيب الفعل
Okay, let's stop here and explain. There's a lot of details. The فعل صحيح, the correct verb is the three types. It should start with سالم. سالم is mean perfect. سالم, you know, and someone is traveling somewhere different from his home. We say, اللهم رده سالما غانما. Oh Allah, return him back سالم. سالم means no hurt, no problem. No suffering.
One piece.
Ghaniman, he is the one who got, you know, a bounties. Ghaniman, he earned something. So Salim means he is perfect. There is no any problem. There is no any issue. You know, that's in good condition. That means Salim. Okay, if it's not Salim, it will be Mahmuz. Mahmuz means there is contain Hamza. Mahmuz from Hamza. Hamza, where is Hamza? Can come in the beginning? أخذ he talks. سأل. سأل سائل ولقد أخذ الله ميثاق بني إسرائيل. الله took the deal and the promise from بني إسرائيل. You know, سأل. سأل سائل بعذاب واقع. سأل من he have asked or he asked it. Here is the Hamza in the middle. أخذ the Hamza in the beginning. بدأ he started. All of this verb أخذ سأل بدأ. ماضي مضارع وأمر. Quickly.
ماضي.
All of them ماضي. How we know? Give me proof.
The, at the end, you have
فتحة. The verb, the فعل ماضي. Without connected to anything, مبني على الفتح. Last letter have فتح. So, الحمد لله, now you mark this is verb and you mark this is فعل ماضي, not any verb. And now you mark it another thing. This is فعل صحيح because there is no why. Wow, California. And now, you know, this is Mahmoud. So now you are collecting a lot of information about the verb. You know? So you know this is verb, that's first information, not now. You know this is فعل ماضي because the last letter أخذ, سأل, بدأ. You know this is صحيح. صحيح because there is no حرف علة contain. And you know this is Mahmoud. Mahmoud contain Hamza. So you know exact types of verb. Mashallah, you know more than Arabic people now. So I'll give you a test of this, but remember, okay? If it's not mahmuz, it will be mudaaf. And this is one of the hardest type of verb in the pronunciation. A lot of people, they are confused because mudaaf means there is tad'if, yani shadda, there is tajdeed. So you have to make stress when you pronounce it. And the mudaaf is the two types, thulazi, you know, consist of three letters, or a bank consists of four letters. So, let's pronounce مضاعف ثلاثي مد ونمد له من العذاب مد not مد شد شد Not shada, you know. Rubai, shak shaka.
But it's only two letters, right? Madda is only two letters.
No, madda is not two letters.
So we are saying like we're splitting
that's
that.
The meaning of mudaaf, يعني تشديد. Madda, if you read it, if you get the root, is madada. So basically is madada. But what's it in the Arabic pronunciation? When you have the same letter repeated, and we use it. Very much in the so we have to gather it. That's why make tad'if. So when I ask you madda, without looking in the pronunciation madda, how many? Don't say two. Don't say mim and dal. There is mim and dal only. There is two letters, but the second one is the double. تزمين تضعيف مضاعف يعني مشدد. So you see, مد I mean strength. You know, مد يده, you know, is give extra time or extend, extend or give extension. This مد. Or مدد, there is noun from مدد, مدد give me extra. Give me مدد, مدد from food, extra food, مدد from this. Sorry. مدد from the soldiers, you know. So مدد anything extra. شد, he pull out. And there is رباعي like شقشقة. You say, النهار يشق شقشقة النهار, the day start. شقشقة. Or زلزلة, إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزلة. وسوسة. وسوسة the verb in the past. الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس. This verb يوسوس في صدور الناس. ماضي مضارع أو أمر. Quickly.
يوسوس مضارع.
مضارع. Why?
I
started as well. أنا إيتو. Can give me quick answer. So وسوس. Okay. In سورة فوسوس إليه الشيطان قال يا آدم فوسوس.
ماضي.
ماضي. وسوس. How you know? The end of the verb. فتحة. وسوس. يو وسوس مضارع. Present. Why? Started with one of the حروف of أنيتو. So والله it's very easy but you have to focus in. So here we are talking about different types of let me fix this. Different types of that's okay, that's fine. Different types of the مضاعف, we have ثلاثي. So don't say this is two. You have to look شتى and you hear مدى. If you say مدى, that's two. مدى, that's three. Okay. شقشقة. Mostly of the مضاعف رباعي, the first and third will be same. The second and fourth will be same. زلزلة. وسوسة. جلجلة. There is no جلجلة. There is the Quran. There is وسوسة and there is زلزلة. وسوسة and زلزلة. Okay. If the verb صحيح is not مهموز, never contain همزة or contain شدة, it will be سالة. So again, how many types of verb صحيح, الفعل الصحيح؟
Three.
سالم مهموز مضاعف. سالم مين؟ No همزة, no شدة. مهموز مين؟ There is
همزة.
همزة. Where is the همزة can come?
Anywhere.
Anywhere. In the beginning. أخذ.
سأل.
In the middle. سأل. In the end. بدأ. If there any همزة, if there is any همزة in the beginning or middle end, it will be مهموز. It will be مهموز. Need to tell همزة. If it's not مهموز, it will be مضاعف. يعني something double. مشدد or مضاعف. Same word. So let's see الرباعي. So let's you're gonna find two letters in front of your eyes, but one of them have a double مدّة, basically مدّدة. You know, شدّة is شددة. Okay, مضاعف رباعي شقشقة زلزلة وسوسة. سالم, there is no hams, there is no تضعيف. Easy, easy guys.
تل
الفعل المعطف.
لو أوله علة بسميه مثال, وسطه علة أجوف
ناقص.
المعتاد المثال أوله علة.
Look at here, we have also four types of فعل معتل. So you have to remember what the meaning of فعل معتل. We explain it here. What the meaning of فعل معتل?
Why?
Have why. One of why. Where? This is a type of verb. This question to answer, where is the حرف علة? Here is the answer. If the حرف علة in the beginning, like وقف, he stand. يأس, he despair. You know, that's مثال.
يأس came, the Hamza said there, right?
No, here we cannot say مهموز. Because if there is حرف علة, because if the مهموز is the branch of صحيح. And صحيح, صحيح shouldn't have any حرف علة. If the verb have حرف عله ذات جود كويشن. وي نيفر اسك ذيس مهموس اور مضاعف، سو يو كانوت فايند ذيس تايبس هير. سو اف ذير از حرف عله معتل، فعل معتل سيك. I will say why sick, but not now. So if the حرف العلة comes the beginning, it will be مثال. مثال also in Arabic mean example. Or types of verb معتل have a حرف علة واو or ألف or ياء in the beginning. You know, أجوف from جوف. جوف يعني middle, you know. أجوف mean in the middle, like قام, صام, نام, قال, the ألف in the middle. Or ناقص in the end, alif or ya or waw in the end. Like da'a, sa'a, masha, jara, ata. So for example here, ata, that's ata is mahmuz or naqis. Ata, you said mahmuz. No, ata is not mahmuz. Because there is harf illa. So harf illa, you have to find it here, naqis. حرف علة the third one. So if the حرف علة first, it will be مثال. If the حرف علة in the middle, it will be أجوف. If the حرف علة in the end. So you learn if you forgot this name, حرف فعل معتل يعني verb have حرف علة. واو ورايف وليا. Can be in the beginning or middle or end. And this example. Please try to memorize. I send you like two video or three video about some verb. You're going to see the verb and you're going to see the photo. You're going to understand the meaning from the photo. So please try to memorize as much as you can. Because inshallah, we'll start the conversation soon. So waqafa, he stand up. Ya Isa, he got despair, you know, or he got depressed. Qala, he said, nama, he slept. Da'a, he made dua. Sa'a, he walked a little faster. Okay, if the fi'l mu'tal is not مثال or أجوف for ناقص can be لفيف. لفيف the verb have two حرف علة. Two حرف علة. لفيف. لفيف mean لفة يعني have a turn. So the حروف العلة make a round around the verb. And the لفيف is two types also. مفروق. مفروق there is divider. There is واو حرف علة right? أنياء حرف علة. وعى. وعى mean he realize. And waqa, waqa means he protect. Waqa, this is the root of taqwa. The verb of taqwa or taqwa is the verb, the root is waqa. Waqa means protect. So taqwa means you protect yourself from the punishment from Allah. You protect yourself from shaitan. That's the meaning of taqwa. So waqa means he realize. And waqa, he protect. Okay, let's look. Where is the harf illa? Waqa, where is the harf illa?
First and last.
First and last. What is the middle? The middle is harf sahih. This is مفروق. مفروق means there is divider. There is حرف صحيح, which is عين, is divider between واو and ياء. Here is the same. وقا. Where is the حرف العلة in وقا? واو and ياء. First and last. Is the كاف حرف علة?
No.
No, this is مفروق also. So the حرف الصحيح is in between two حرف علة. That's مفروق. لفيف, because there is two. More than one حرف علة, there is two حرف علة. That's لفيف. المفروض because there is divider which is حرف صحيح. You know, here الحرف الأول والثالث معتل. الحرف الأول, the first and the third one is معتل. اللفيف المقرون. The حروف المقرون يعني gathered together. قرين. قرين someone with you. You know, قال قرينه, the one who stick on you. Never leave you. ومقرون يعني something together. Here كوا. كوا يعني ironing. When you have an iron to make ironing for your clothes, this is كوا. Or روا. روا when you water your farm, that's watering, that's روا. Or روا from رواية. رواية يعني narration. When you say the story, you make رواية. روا. There is two meaning for روا. Okay. So look at where is the حرف علة in كوا. Yeah and wow. Second and third together. And كاف is not حرف علة. It's حرف صحيح. That's separate. Just مقرون. So واو and ياء is together. So there is no divider.
Second and third makes it مقرون.
Second and third. Yes. روى also second and third. So الثاني الحرف الثاني explain here. الحرف الثاني والثالث معتل. Okay.
So why
What?
we haven't Sahi and Muatan?
Yeah, we have, this is some introduction for this story. It's not the fi'l al-damir. So you have to know the difference of the verb to recognize when you see the verb in anyone. All of these verbs in the Quran. So
why is
I
it
want,
broken?
What?
Why is Muattal? What is the sickness?
Oh, why is Mu'tal? Okay. Because harf al-illah is always, there's many problems for harf al-illah. First, in the makharij, there is no specific area for harf al-illah. So when you study the makharij, you remember who, you say, ah, you feel it. Okay. Ta, top of tongue. Ta, back of tongue. Can you tell me the alif? Where? You put Hamza and say alif. The voice will not end. So the scholar, they didn't recognize which spot exactly the alif comes from. The alif was half an alif. Wow, the same. Put Hamza and say ooh. Will not stop. But put Hamza between before Jim. Aj. Voice stop. Seen. Say seen. Yes. You're gonna stop. But any one of harf illa, they'll never stop. This is illa also. They cannot stand it here. So the waw or alif or ya, there is problem in the makhraj. We cannot recognize exact area. In the verb in the ilm al-sarf, we have the language levels. We say in the beginning, in the first class, the language, there is the phonics, which is sawtiyat, and ilm al-sarf, the morphology, how to correct the word and the verb and the noun. And we have the syntax, which is a grammar, and we have the semantics, which is the meaning or behind the meaning, the metaphysics of the meaning, you know, something behind the meaning. That's all of the level of the. Then this class is about the morphology, raf al-illa. For example, how the verb waqa, which is the verb waqa, how can get the name taqwa? This is a very long story. So the verb waqa, let me explain it to you. I know it's very hard, but I'm trying to make it simple. The verb waqa is like this. Waqa. There is different types of verb. We say in Arabic, al-mujarrad wal-mazid. The main letter and the extra letter. So you can add any letters to any verb to add meaning. So waqa means protect. If you want to say ittaqa, the verb ittaqa, you have to say ittaqa. All of this madi. Ittaqa. There is problem in the pronunciation, ittaqa. So we need, we're going to add the waw and ta, sorry. Waw and ta. Because when you want to add any letter to verb, there is a specific letter you have to add from. You cannot add any letter to the verb from your mind. The group that, inshallah, later on, the group of the letter that we can add it is a group of sa'altumuniha. Sa'altumuniha, don't write it now. Sa'altumuniha, this group that you can add it to any verb. And each one will give you different meaning when you add it. So when we try to add to waqa, the allowed letter is alif and ta. But after we add it, the sound, the balance of the word is not matching. Here is the morphology with two. We'll start. We say, how can make the word matching to one another? To make the letter friendly to one another. You know, to make a balance in the skill of the word. That's something I know complicated. Inshallah, later on, that's in the second course, in the grammar course. That's why they switch well to letter matching with the next letter that we added. We add alif and ta. So we're gonna switch waw to verb to be matching. And we add ta and we put double on the ta. But the root is waqa, then we add alif and ta, ew taqa, the sound is not matching and we make it التقى. التقى mean he feared Allah. But وقى someone protect. التقى someone he tried to protect himself. So when you say التقى الله mean protect yourself because no one will protect you. But وقى الأب أبناءه. The father to protect his kids. So when the father sit down and the kids is playing around and he fall down, so he gonna pick him up. This is waqa. Someone will pick you up. Someone will help you. Someone will protect you. But when he say ittaqa, he protected himself. And when we say ittaqila, and protect yourself because no one will protect you. So the verb give meaning, you know. Let's go here, guys, to the types of verb again to review it. This is the point that I said. إذا اجتمعت الهمزة مع حروف العلة اجتمع يعني gather. If we have a gathering همزة with حروف العلة فهذا الفعل معتل. We consider the verb is معتل. Like رأى. رأى there is همزة in the middle. محموس in the middle but there is حرف علة. So it will be معتل. It will not be محموس. Because محموس is kind of صحيح. No, it will be معتل. Or also جاء. جاء there is ألف and there is همزة. جيم ألف همزة three different letters. So جاء the همزة it will be we don't consider the همزة we we'll consider حرف العلة جاء it will be معتل. This is the rule. Okay. جزاك الله خير. We need it.
Okay. بسم الله. بسم الله.
Okay, let's review before we go to another session. So الفعل, there is two types of فعل, صحيح and معتل. You know, this introduction is very, very important. When we link the ضمائر, it will be easy, inshallah. So we have the صحيح and معتل. صحيح, there is never contain any حرف علة, why? And there is three types, محموز, مضاعف, سالم. What's the meaning of محموز?
همزة.
Contain همزة. Where?
Anywhere.
Anywhere. ما معنى مضاعف؟
شدة.
شدة. How many types?
ثلاثة رباعي.
So مادة and شدة. How many letters?
Three,
not two. Okay. رباعي يعني؟
زلزلة.
First and third same. Second and fourth same. Okay. سالم mean there is no
همزة.
There is no
شدة.
شدة. Easy. The three types of فعل صحيح. The فعل معتل is four types. First one is مثال. Mean أوله حرف علة. First is حرف علة. وقف يائسا. أجوف mean. Say guys, are you sleepy?
No.
In the middle.
Middle.
حرف العلة in the middle. Like قال. I want you read. قال and نام. Okay. ناقص mean. حرف العلة where in the end at the end. Okay. دعا
دعا سعى
سعى. I want to read because some people say سعي. No سعى. You know how you know this is سعى or سعي. You know look at
all that straight
زعين. If زعين فتحة its meaning will be سعى. If it's سعي, سعي is noun. سعي is noun. سعى is verb. سعى فتحة فتحة سكون. سعي فتح سكون سكون.
You know when we in Urdu when we write that there is a zabar there is a zabar which is fatha
zabar yeah.
There is a straight line also.
There is number one.
Number one.
We do it in Arabic. We know we do it in the Quran. The regular dictation in Arabic different from Quran dictation. From the Quran dictation we'll find number one when the ya that mean this alif not ya.
This does the ya.
Yeah. But in the regular dictation will not show you. So you have to recognize the verb. When you student, they say sa'i. They say sa'i. Yeah, I'm training the kids to read without haraka, without zabar their page.
Yeah.
You know, but it's very hard. That's why they read wrong because they don't know the meaning.
Yeah.
So I'm collect. I'm you know, explain to them how to read it. Yeah.
Sure. Can this wine is not silent? Like sorry, yeah, right? Wine.
This is حرف علة because of the حركة of عين. The حركة is سعى. Here it should have فتحة. Not سعي. If it's كسرة it will be سعي. سعي. But there is no verb looks is sa'i. You know, if someone says sa'i, no. There's no meaning. You know, but sa'a, sa'a, and the noun is sa'i. Da'a, da'a also some people, they write it wrong. Da'a from du'a is with alif. Some people, they write it with ya. From ya, be careful, different word. From what? From ya? This is da'a. Someone make du'a. This word have only one way to read it. Da'i. Da'i. Da'i mean liar. Or someone pretend, someone say something fake. This is da'i. There is no da'a like this in Arabic. That's wrong. But this word, this shape is da'i. So you know Musaylama al-Kazzab? Musaylama al-Kazzab. He said, I'm a prophet, and he make a fake story. This is da'i. Or da'i also, if someone says, this is my son, and this is not his son. He make a pounding, you know. This is da'i. Someone lied or something, something fake. A da'i, yani fake, something fake. So different from da'a. There is no da'a by ya. The da'a is by al. Very, very important in the dictation rules. This is sa'a, it's not sa'i. Sa'a, you know. So again, how many types of fa'l na mu'tal? Yalla say. Misal. Ajwaf.
Ajwaf.
Naqis. Yafir. Misal yani?
Fastidhi ghay. Waqafa.
Awalu, can you read in Arabic? Awaluhu harf al.
Awalu harf
al. Yani in the beginning there is harf al. Ajwaf mean? Wasatuhu.
Second
one. Harf al. Naqis yani?
Akhirah.
Akhiruhu harf al. Now, mashallah, you talk in Arabic. And al-naqis, sorry, al-lafif naw'an, lafif, mafruq, wa-lafif mafruq. Al-lafif mafruq, al-harf, al-awwal, wa-thalith mu'tal. The first and third. Okay, wa-lafif al-makrun, al-harf.
Sa'i wa-sulalith
mu'tal. Mean the first, al-awwal, laysa mu'tal. Mu'tal, not mu'tal. No. معتل there is شدة on لا yeah
الله.
الفعل الصحيح والفعل المعتل معتل there is فتحة on تاء okay this is very very important okay any question about here I know many different types but it's easy inshallah any question please for example
three letters only like the فعل معتل like all of them three letters word
mostly of them can be four Can be four, like awqafa. Awqafa. You know, awqafahu al-mudir. The director, he stopped him. So awqafa can be four. If you say also awqafa, it will be mithal. How you know if it's four or five? You have to back to the root. Here, they give three examples because the three in the past mean the root of the verb. So awqafa for istawqafa. So that's a good question also. Let me give you another word. Awqafa. Istawqafa. Here, there is harf illa. Someone will say mahmuz. No, cannot be mahmuz. Because ma'amuz is sahih and there is harf illa. So how I know? You have to back to the root. The root is waqafa. This is the root. Because this is misal ago of naqis, you have to back to the third, the three root of the verb. Awqafa, this is an extra verb. How you know? Istawqafa. Ist mean he requests. Any verb started with ist mean request. Istawqafa mean he requested him to stop. Or when I say, Istawqafatni ayah. There's a lot of scholars, they say, Istawqafani ayah fi kitabillah, or Istawqafatni ayah. So one ayah stopped me. Mean I stopped to think about it. Istawqafani ayah, or Istawqafatni ayah. Istawqafatni mean this ayah request me to stop. Mean this the meaning of the ayah attract my mind, so I stop to read it and to get the meaning to ponder. So a lot of يعني scholars they said this word استوقفني آية في كتاب الله استوقفتني آية في كتاب الله استوقفتني the stop me to request to think about it. So when you see the verb like this, that's معتل. A معتل which معتل مثال because this is the root, this is extra. That's inshallah next class we're going to study المجرد والمزيد. المجرد the main root of the verb can be three or four. Some مجرد is four. And المزيد مزيد. This word in Urdu also مزيد. When you make extra letter and what is the letter that you can add it and what is the meaning if you add it. It's a long, but it's a wonderful story about the verb. Now we are in the story verb, that's the longest verb. So awqafa mean someone stop. Waqafa mean I stop myself. Waqafa rajulu lis-sala. I stand. No one helped me to stand. But awqafa al-imam al-musallin. The imam awqafa, imam helped the people to stand, to line up. Istawqafa, he requests to stop. So every addition is given different meaning. So, but all of them is from the root waqafa. From the root waqafa, yani stop.
So
wukuf is
isma.
Wukuf.
Waqafa, right?
Yeah. There is waqafa. Waqafa is ism. Oh, you give me another word. This is, you say, waqfat arafat. Waqafa. Waqafa. صاف السيلة وقفة وقفة means stand standing وقفة وقافة وقافة all مفتوح وقفة verb أو قافة the واو silent okay استوقف verb وقفة وقفة عرفات or الوقوف بعرفة وقفة is a noun. الوقوف also noun. الوقوف standing. And there is meaning between وقفة and الوقوف. وقفة means standing for one time. When I say وقفة, means standing for one time because the day of عرفة is one day. So وقفة. You know, if you said وقفة, different meaning. يعني the looks if you're standing. وقفة معتدلة. You stand straight. وقفة مائلة. You know, like you make it like a curve. If you make a kasra for the waw, that mean you mean the looks of the verb. You know, if you make it fatha, mean the time. How many times? You see the difference? If you say this is alukuf, the standing, regular standing. Long standing, short standing, whatever, but is wukuf. Wukuf yani standing. Okay. In the Arabic, what happened to the TV?
I think you pressed the button. Turn it on.
Oh, from here?
Yeah, it just turned off because I think you...
It slipped?
Yeah, it's really pressed.
Oh, hello. We didn't see you. Okay. So when you drive in the inner street, they say ممنوع الوقوف. They said ممنوع الوقوف, you are not allowed to stop. ممنوع الوقوف, you mean you are not allowed to make a parking. ممنوع يعني forbidden. ممنوع الوقوف, يعني you are not allowed to stop here.
Yeah, the stop sign says.
Okay. Yeah. No, there's opposite of a stop sign. A stop sign is قف. Stop sign, فعل أمر. قف. The verb, the first waqafa. Okay, this is our topic of today. We didn't start yet. Class is almost over, but we didn't start. Here, what we study now. Now we can link the Salim Mahmoud Mudaf with the Ta'al Fa'al Nal Fa'alin Nun Niswa Alif Al Ithnain Wal Jama'a Al Mukhataba. This is our pronoun. How we can link this verb with that? Inshallah, let me pass this. Let him fill up the schedule. Okay. Okay. That's what we need. That's inshallah, we'll do something and we'll stop inshallah. So I say, when you want to stop, qif. Or tawakkaf. Qif from the root waqafa. Qif yani stop. Mostly likely if the verb when you turn it from madi to am, if it's mu'tal, that's inshallah, we're going to cancel one letter or two letters. If you turn فعل معتل to أم, that's different topic. That's here, وقفة, you're going to cut off واو. We say قف, صام, صم, قام, قم. In the hadith, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, when you request who can go sneak among the disbeliever and to give me the good news, no one say, want to stand up. And the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم say, قم يا حزيفة. حزيفة, get up. He cannot say no. He get up. He got up. قم يعني stand up. You know, قم. In the accent, we say, أوم. In Egyptian accent, أوم. But supposed to be قم. قاف ميم. That mean the root, قام. قام mean he stand up. But in the verb, and when you turn the فعل from ماضي, and the فعل الماضي was معتل, most likely gonna cut some verb. If it's like أجوف, like قام, صام, نعم, you know, you're gonna cut off the middle one. If it's مثال, like وقف, you say قف, you know, وسم, سم, وعد, عد, you're gonna cut off the first one. Inshallah, that's a different story. Inshallah, we'll talk later on. Let's complete here how you can connect the فعل صحيح سالم مهموس مضاعف to the pronoun. Let's see. So سالم, the verb is كتب. سالم يعني there is no حرف علة, there is no تضعيف, there is no شدة. Like كتب, I wrote it. كتب, وهنا تقطع تاء الفاعل. Say
كتبت.
Is this كتبت تاء الفاعل? Are you sure?
كتبت.
كتبت أو كتبت أو كتبتي. كتبت is not the فعل. Again, let me write down this. This is very, very important.
مادي. مادي 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 فتح.
كا. تا. بت. كتبت. Who can complete the sentence with the subject, with فعل?
كتبا is the
مادي. Okay, كتبت. Complete the sentence. كتبت. Who كتبت? Subject is female or female?
Male.
Because
you remember تاء الفاعل?
كتبت.
تاء الفاعل should have فتحة or ضم or كسر. Remember? The تاء that have silent is not تاء الفاعل. It's تاء التأنيث. Again. The تاء, look at the حركة of تاء, even without looking, by listening.
كتبت.
تاء is silent. So the subject should be female. Should be girl or woman. كتبت فاطمة الدرس. كتبت إسراء الدرس. كتبت فهيمة الدرس. Okay, كتبت منى الدرس. كتبت أمل الدرس. So when you say كتبت, the تاء is silent, that means تاء التأنيث. Be careful. تاء التأنيث means the subject coming is female. When I say تاء الفاعل, mean me or you or her. They say كتبت ضم. كتبت أنت. كتبت يعني أنا. كتبت يعني أنت. كتبتي يعني أنت for female. But كتبت is تاء التأنيث, not تاء الفعل. So تاء الفعل again should have ضم or فتح or كسر. Okay, so this is فعل سالم كتبت with تاء الفاعلين. كتبنا, that's easy. كتبنا, we wrote. كتبت يعني I wrote. كتبنا, we wrote.
كتبني.
كتبني or كتبن.
كتبن.
كتبن. نون
سايلنس.
النسوة means the subject is group of women, group of women. And this is كتبنا, the ماضي, يكتبنا. ये एक मुदारा उक्तोपना अम्र كتبنا يكتبنا اكتبنا in both of them the noon has ضمة والفتحة والكسرة
فتحة
فتحة والوالدات سورة البقرة 233 والوالدات يرضعن أولادهن the mothers are breasting feeding the kids يرضعن يعني give breastfeeding you know يرضعن the noon is a فتحة this noon النسوة always have فتحة Always build on Fatah. Please try to memorize. I know it's very hard, the complicated rules, but with the repeating, I will keep repeating. I will never feel bored. I will keep repeating, even if I forgot, I will keep repeating. So, Nun al Niswa has Fatha, Ta'al Fa'al, Dhamma wa Fatha, Kasa, Na is always silent on the Alif. You know, Alif al Isnain. Who can read it?
Two.
I know two. Kataba. The Alif silent. Okay, that's Fa'al Madi. If it's Fa'al Mudara. يكتباني with the فعل الماضي مضارع the noon has كسر يكتباني الولدان the two boys يكتباني الدرس two boys they wrote or they are writing the درس the lesson اكتبا someone will ask why اكتبا there is no noon يكتبان there is no noon that's different story also inshallah later on but now we are asking about how we can link the verb وإذا الفاعل من الفاعلين نون النسوة ألف الاثنين واو الجماعة mean the subject is group of male read it كتبوا يكتبون مضارع كتبوا ماضي يكتبون
يكتبون
مضارع
اكتبوا
اكتبوا برافو عليك ما شاء الله اوكي يا المخاطبة when you talk to girl so when I say كتبت فاطمة فاطمة is not here كتبت تاء التأنيث كتبت فاطمة فاطمة is not here فوين فاطمة is front of me say اكتبي or أنت تكتبين there is no فعل ماضي وزياء المخاطبة there is no فعل ماضي وزياء المخاطبة cannot come cannot come but there is a مضارع أمر say تكتبين يا فاطمة أنت تكتبين جيدا oh فاطمة you are writing very good you know
why ماضي is not there for
cannot come. You cannot say. You cannot say. كتبين.
You already in present.
Yeah.
Present.
So yeah, because this is مخاطبة.
Talking.
مخاطبة someone in the front of you.
Right now.
Someone you cannot imagine someone in front of you and the verb in the past. It's impossible. مخاطبة يعني to talk to someone. So you talk to someone that means should be present or future or am. Cannot be ماضي. But it just makes the schedule. That's why you're gonna get ibra. Even here, mudara for kataba, mudara, we cannot say yaktabtu. Yaktabtu, you cannot say. Because I'm talking about myself. So I say kataptu. If I mudara, I say aktubu. Cannot be with the fa'l. Aktubu. You know, if it's amr, I say oktub. Not oktubtu, not oktubutu. Cannot be. Yeah, cannot. You cannot order yourself and no one watch you. You will be crazy.
I might order something for myself in the past.
Yeah, yeah, but good to us. Katabna. Katabna in mean we wrote. You cannot say فعل مضارع. We katabna. You know, we are, how we can say
in English, you say we are writing.
Yeah. No, we can say naktubu. Because instead of na, there is one of the anaitu. Anaitu, the H letter in them. So here we say naktubu. So the noon in the beginning of verb mean we are writing. But we cannot connect nal fa'alin. Nal fa'alin can be in the past only. You know, even here nal fa'alin cannot be with the amr. We cannot say, when you say, if you need amr, you say uktubu. Wawul jama'a can be with the wawul jama'a. Not nal fa'alin. You know, cannot give amr for ourselves also in this type of verb. Nun al nisa, you can have four, you can have the three, all of them. Al banatu or fatayatu, the girls, katabna al dars. They wrote the al banatu, yaktubna al dars. They are writing. Ya banat, uktubna al dars. Write down the lesson. Okay. Alif al-Isnain, kataba
يكتبان اكتب، والجماعة كتبوا يكتبون. إن شاء الله gonna continue this class. It's very very important. I know if you understand this pronoun, I know our life is very complicated. I will repeat it again. Review the past and continue. Inshallah with this very 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 important. How you link the pronoun with the verb and this very introduction. Sahih and Mu'tal very very important. So inshallah.
We are going to do this is like only all the Sahih, right? Like how about Mu'tal?
Mu'tal. That's next flyer. You want to turn it when you finish this? Mu'tal. So we just finished this, inshallah. Our review it is very, very important. I know it's very hard, but inshallah we'll repeat it next time and review. Because Aisha is very close. Jazakumullah khairan for watching. And inshallah we'll continue next time. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Can we?